Former agricultural town is home to one of the most mysterious structures in North America. A stone garden made of sculpted blocks of ancient coral, some weighing 30 tons. It's called the Coral Castle. Spread over several acres, the complex formations and intricate designs of the stone walls and sculptures marvel tourists. But unlike other great structures around the world, this site is not ancient.
Ed says this in his pamphlet, Magnetic Current, that real gravity is actually real magnet. So if you reverse the magnet forces with a force of some kind of electromagnetic radio, perhaps frequency, you can then make these rocks not as heavy as they seem otherwise, and therefore you can lift them.
This man swears he's cracked. He's building his own Stonehenge in his Flint, Michigan backyard to prove it. Wally Wallington's not a scientist, but he knows a thing or two about moving rocks.
That's a 300-pound block. This is a 1,600-pound block. Not too difficult.
He's a retired construction worker whose passion is moving heavy items. His feats always draw a crowd, mostly family.
I thought he's crazy. Who cares about moving blocks around? But then when you look at the magnitude of the weights that he's moving around, it is really impressive, and he's not using any equipment or anything.
In playing with blocks, Wally thinks he's discovered how Stonehenge was moved.
This is my first Stonehenge arch I permanently put in place. It's three blocks, they weigh over a ton each.
It's all based on a very simple technique.
I found a simple explanation for this, to move a block about the weight of a minivan, would be to place a stone underneath it. And once I balance on it, I can spin it. Of course, with that spin, you've seen I didn't go anywhere. But I got two handles on my lever, and I could place another stone on this side. Now, every time I spin a half rotation on each stone, I move the block horizontally the distance between the stones. With my own output, I could move a one-ton block 300 feet per hour.
Using this technique, he's moved everything from one-ton blocks to buildings.
This is 19,200 pounds. Yeah, it's 128 cubic feet of concrete.
Today, Wally hopes to solve it. He'll put one of his theories to the test and try to stand this 19,200-pound block by himself.
I've tried to do this without any mechanical machinery at all. I've used mostly sticks and stones for my equipment. No pulleys, no hoists, no metal levers. Just try to use gravity, too, I believe is my favorite tool.
Whoop. The first goal is getting this block 3 feet off the ground.
In order to move it up to this point, I just rock the block back and forth, adding weight to that end, and that opens a gap on this side, and just slide a board in. Then I add the weight to that end.
There she goes.
And slide a board in on this end.
This shoring box acts like a jack, slowly raising the block. It's 3 feet off the ground, but tomorrow is the big experiment.
The first thing I'm going to do here is release this temporary shoring I have set and come over here, release some of my counterweights, and that's going to put the entire weight of the block on this rope. So then I'm going to release the rope, come back in, and the rope's going to be my brake. I'm going to guide it into the pit. Ready? Yes! All right. Now just start spraying the sand. The sand will wash out and the block will start coming down.
Once the sand is washed from the pit, the block's own weight slowly stands it up.